tonight on Tom's River Schools Today, we will take a look at your upcoming weather.
And as always, we'll take a look at some of the events from around the school district. Tom's River Schools Today starts in 2 minutes.
Tom's River Schools Today for Tuesday, March the 12th, 2019. I'm Nicole Platton.
And I'm Ryan Sicardo. Later on tonight, we will check out your weather and we look at how one swimmer is making waves in and out of the pool.
But up first tonight, we take a look at our elementary schools in our elementary happening segment.
Starting off our elementary happenings, all students be sure to wear your school colors and support your school every day.
Let's take a look at today's random fact of the day.
Hi, I'm Mikhail Baker with TV21's Random Fact of the Day. Did you know the original prototype for the Star Trek Enterprise spaceship was stolen from creator Gene Roddenberry's unlocked van?
A North Carolina man is behind the bars after authorities say he has stolen an SUV that had two young children inside. Their mother had strapped at a conference store for gas, feeling like she was in a safe environment. But as Brian Rain reports, in a second sense of security fell apart.
I was going to the gas station to get gas.
It was late, past 11 on Saturday night, and it was cold. Gabrielle Rand had her children, 7-year-old Jalen and 3-year-old Amaya, in the back seat of her Chevy Tahoe. She had to pay with cash.
But I was like, literally, I'm only going to be in there for like 2 seconds.
So. As she walked up to the door of the Handy Hugo's, a young man approached. Said he had no place to stay. She shrugged it off until she was at the cash register.
And I look, and he's standing there by my truck door like this. And I'm like looking at him like he's looking at me in the store, and I'm looking at him, but he's got his hand on my door. And I'm like, you know, please don't do it. Please don't do it. Please don't do it.
But he did do it. He drove off.
I ran through the parking lot chasing him, screaming, you know, my baby's in the back, in the back. My babies are in there. My babies are in there.
Somebody at the store called 911. Clayton police say the driver had no idea children were in the back seat until they screamed. Their mom had left two phones in the Tahoe, and the man asked the children if there was someone he could call to pick them up. She says the driver phoned the last number dialed. It was Amaya's father, Lamont Alston.
He tells Lamont, you know, he's sorry the truck is stuck in the mud, that the kids are unharmed. You know, he can't return the truck. He can't bring the kids back because the police is looking for him.
But she says he convinced the driver to give an address. Police and sheriff's deputies responded to the suspect's home about a mile from the gas station. They found the children unhurt and arrested 22-year-old Brian Keith Allen, who police say was trying to get to Dunn.
I mean, one, I cried, I hugged my babies, you know, I told them I was sorry.
And now she's telling parents,
take your babies. This was a lesson learned from me. Take your babies with you. You know, if you got to unbuckle the car.
It's time to take a trip around the world in our 60-second road trip. Can you guess where we are today? I was tired of my lady. Together too long, like a worn out recording of a favorite song. So while she lay there sleeping, I read the paper in bed, and in the personal columns there was this letter I read. If you like pina colada,
Maddie and Megan just chilling there, like what?
6 months since ADC Runner was attacked. Her fiance is making plans to honor her. 35-year-old Wendy Martinez was training for the Boston Marathon when she died. Now her fiance will run it himself to keep her memory alive. Heather Graff has the story.
The city of Washington, D.C. is full of runners.
The will to run comes in different forms for different people.
It was a way to engage, to relax, to feel empowered.
But Daniel Incapié will tell you his motivation is love.
What keeps you going?
Her. How she would have wanted me to react to this.
Daniel's fiance, an avid runner named Wendy Martinez, who in September of 2018 was working to qualify for the Boston Marathon. But during an evening run in Logan Circle, she was stabbed and killed in what police say was a random attack.
We're not going to let her life be shut down. And this is how we're going to accomplish that.
Keeping his fiance's dream alive, Daniel told us, by signing up for the Boston Marathon himself.
So I only started training actually a few weeks ago. So it's been a little bit challenging to get back on track. Probably it's not going to be my fastest race, but I'm going to run it with my heart.
26.2 miles, during which Daniel will be raising money for a nonprofit named in Wendy's honor.
My goal and what I know that I'm going to accomplish is cross that finish line together with her.
The love of his life, still by his side.
She'll be right there with me.
Motivating him, and perhaps all runners, to face their fears.
She will probably say, I want you guys to go run.
Heather Graff.
Just us raising our hands and just crossing that finish line.
ABC 7 News.
Now we are going to take a short break, but coming up next, we take a look at our intermediate happenings.
And we also take a look at your weather, so stick around. We'll be right back.
Thank you.
second chance for a break that would make it okay. There's always some reason to feel not good enough, and it's hard at the end of the day. I need some distraction. Oh,
apparel is available and on display in the front entrance of the building. Order forms are available in the main office of the school.
It is now time for our environmental tip of the day. Each day we will bring a tip that will help save the environment. Let's take a look at today's tip.
Don't tap out. Teach children to turn off the water while brushing their teeth. Leaving the tap running during the recommended 2 minutes of brushing can waste up to 5 gallons of water a day.
Every day on this show, we will be bringing you a tip of the day. So stay tuned tomorrow as we give another way to help save the environment.
It is now time for another break. Coming up later in the show, we will take a look at your high school happenings.
Keep reading. Tom's River
School. Tom's River Schools Today. We'll be right back.
It's fun to lose and to pretend she's overboard and self-assured. I know a dirty word. Here we are now, entertain us.
Starting off our high school happenings, attention students and staff. The school store is now open to serve you. We are stocked with all your Raider apparel needs, including Champion and Under Armour brands. The school store is open every day after school from 1:40 to 2 p.m. We also have Yoo-hoo, Snapple, and water for $1, as well as many delicious snacks to get you energized for your after-school practices. Stop in soon. It's time to get Raiderized.
Attention all students. The homeroom with the best attendance will win a free breakfast.
Looking for community service hours while having fun? Volunteer to be a tutor at East Dover, Cedar Grove, or Hooper Ave Elementary after school for an hour at your convenience, please. See me, Fitzgerald, in W30 or N23 for an application packet.
Let's now take a look at what grinds our gears.
Hi, my name is Vinny, and what really grinds my gears is when people bite their pencil in class.
It is now time for us to take a short break. After the break, we take a look at our three-day forecast.
Thomas River Schools Today, we'll be right back.
Mothers lose their babies to gun crimes. You'll always be your mother's baby. So before you commit a gun crime, think about who you'll leave behind. Gun crimes hit home.
Starting off tonight's sports, you're only as young as you feel, or so the saying goes. And Flo Miler of Shelburne, Vermont, feels young, very young. She acts young, too. The octogenarian has a unique golden years hobby, competing in pole vaulting events around the world and breaking records, Liz Strepso reports.
Maybe.
Flo Miler.
And you turn and you bring it around.
Is teaching these seniors at the residence at Shelburne Bay a thing or two about fitness.
I told them that they have a fantastic program here, that to really sign up and get active.
Staying active has been a staple in the Shelburne residence life. At age 65, she picked up pole vaulting and hasn't stopped since.
I like challenges, and pole vault is very challenging.
She's the world's oldest pole vaulter and continues to compete globally in a variety of events.
I'll do high jump, long jump, triple jump, The shot, the pentathlon.
Next week, the world record holder will be traveling to Poland to compete in the World Masters Athletics Championships. And in June, she's off to New Mexico to participate in the National Senior Games.
I've made a lot of friends throughout these 25 years. A lot of friends.
She shares her story, hoping to inspire others.
All right. It makes me so happy to see people come up to me and say, "You have inspired me to really get active." That's a wonderful feeling.
And as far as she's concerned, the sky's the limit.
In June, I turn 85. So I am going to break a lot of new records.
Let's now take a look at our three-day forecast coming up tomorrow. It will be cloudy with a high of 45 and low of 37. For Thursday, it stays cloudy with a high of 52 and low of 45. And finally, for Friday, it will be a rainy with a high of 58 and low of 42.
They gotta slow it down. Wrapping up tonight's show, Nina Al-Raifi is a swimmer with Down syndrome competing in the 2019 Special Olympics. Originally Syrian, India, and her family relocated to Bulgaria due to the civil war that tore her country apart. Although this isn't her first time at the Games and winning gold many times before, this is the first time she will be representing Bulgaria. We speak to Nina about what the Special Olympics and swimming means to her, while her mother talks about the challenges she faced on Syria having a child with special needs.
If I get gold medal, I will be happy, super happy. I feel good from swimming. For Olympics, I went to many places. Dubai, Abu Dhabi, Egypt, Athens, Damascus. I remember from Syria, my coach, friends, my center. I need to go back.
First, we warm up.
In Syria, people used to, for example, when you go to a restaurant or a place, public place, people used to look at her because she's different, of course.
I feel happy when I'm traveling.
Remember, if you have a story you would like us to cover,
or if you have any announcements about an upcoming event, please send it to the interschool mail at the TV studio at High School East, or you can email us at tv21@trschools.com.
Also, be sure to tune in to TV21 throughout the day to catch the snow as we bring you stories from around the district. Also, please take a look at our website, www.trschools.com, TV21.
Well, that wraps up tonight's show. For Tom's River Schools Today, I'm Ryan Sicardo.
And I'm Nicole Platten. Have a great night.